Have you been enjoying it, meeting all of the Falling Skies fans here in the UK?
Oh, yeah, it's really nice to see that there's people that enjoy the show. I'm really glad to see how many people love it. Well, I think, you know, when I first started the show, I thought I was only going to do 3 episodes. That's what I agreed to do. And somehow I ended up doing 5 years. I think what happened was I became very attached to the show. I was planning on dying on the 3rd episode, but then when they didn't kill me, I was glad they didn't, because it had become a family for me, and I felt like I had to win against the aliens before I left. I'm not saying if we do or we don't, but... And I think the thing that's interesting about Colonel Weaver is, I talk about this, that he began with quite a mask on. Very, very, and he had to in order to suddenly become this leader of this group. And during the course of the 5 years, little cracks have appeared in that mask, and we've come to know a little more who he is. And he's kind of done the opposite of what Tom Mason has done, which Tom has become harder, and Weaver has sort of opened his heart a little bit, which has been an interesting dynamic. Well, that was when he found his daughter after thinking that his entire family had been killed. He, of course, opened up and found a different kind of hope and lost her. And would have gone under, but I think there's even a scene right after he's lost her where Matt, the young boy, comes up and hugs him. And there's something in his subconscious at that point that realizes, I've made a family here that I have a responsibility and a love for, that I can, you know, I can still have hope to fight for them and to be with them, you know, even though I've lost the most meaningful thing in my life. There's meaning inside this family, if that makes sense. Yeah, well, Noah's a really great actor, you know, he's really good to work with, and he and I had a good chemistry together. We could really play with each other and never knew what we were going to do next. Every take would be a new experiment. I mean, we'd try it one way and then try it another way, and he was always game to go wherever I was going, and I was always game to go wherever he was going. And, you know, you live through a lot doing a show like this, and there's a core group of us that were doing it since 2009, which is a long time ago. You know, and you become pretty close to people when you have to survive a kind of war-like situation, you know, for 20 hours a day sometimes, you know.
Well, the physical aspect of the role was something that really appealed to you. Can you talk a little bit more about what you as an actor get out of that kind of performing?
I think because when I did stage work, you know, years ago, a lot of the plays I did were very physical. And, you know, you get into movies and sometimes you're like just stuck. You know, you have to be still and you're just talking to another person, you know, and you don't have, unless you're doing an action movie like Armageddon or something. But so I miss that physicality of the stage, which you don't often get in films. And with Falling Skies, you got that physicality. And I love it, you know. I would like to do physical stuff all the time with the body. Well, I always like it when we have horses. So we had horses for...
They took them away. What happened to the horses?
I have no idea what happened. Somebody said that there were people back in Charleston that ate them for food because they were starving. I mean, I'm kidding, but that's the only justification for losing our horses.
You talked about Weaver revealing himself as the series went along. Do you feel that in season 5 then he really is completely laid bare? It's maybe a slightly different kind of man that we've grown to know over the previous 4 series.
He's definitely a different kind of man, or at least he's shown a little bit who he really is. But we never totally reveal who he is, even in the 5 seasons. We never really see who he is. We get glimpses. You know, I always, you know, it's a given that that Tom and Weaver were great together, but I always liked it when Weaver had scenes with women because it was such an interesting dynamic, you know, especially in the beginning when he was so held back and a woman with a lot of heart would be dealing with him. I found that to be really fun to figure out how he would react to a certain openness, you know, and how he would be touched by it or not touched by it, you know. So I liked, like, scenes like with Lourdes or something, which was the weirdest, like, pairing of 2 characters. But that dynamic was interesting to me.
What are you most proud of, looking back at the work you've done on stage, on screen, on the big screen?
You know, I always feel like I can't say favorites because it would be like cheating on my other characters and projects. So that's always a hard question for me. Some of my stage work I feel pretty good about because, you know, the actor has complete control on stage, whereas I can do something in TV or film, and some editor is either going to make it better or he's going to make it not what I did in a way that makes me very angry. I'd like to play somebody who's like very, very alienated and outcast that somehow ends up being a hero. Someone who's cut off from the world and very lonely and very lost and people don't get along with them, and yet somehow through that alienation and loneliness there's something to be proud of, if that makes sense.
Do you have a message, I guess, particularly to Falling Skies fans who followed the series and loved it from episode one to our final series coming up?
I'm glad you've been watching Falling Skies, and I think that if you watch carefully, there's secrets inside of Falling Skies that you can decipher if you watch close enough.